Thanks for joining us here on CBN News Midday. I'm Ephraim Graham. Topping your news at this hour, President Obama delivers a much-anticipated speech on the U.S. response to the citizens' uprising in the Middle East and North Africa.
The question before us is what role America will play as this story unfolds. For decades, the United States has pursued a set of core interests in the region, countering terrorism and stopping the spread of nuclear weapons, securing the free flow of commerce and safeguarding the security of the region, standing up for Israel's security, and pursuing Arab-Israeli peace. We will continue to do these things with the firm belief that America's interests are not hostile to people's hopes. They're essential to them. We believe that no one benefits from a nuclear arms race in the region or al-Qaeda's brutal attacks. We believe people everywhere would see their economies crippled by a cutoff in energy supplies. As we did in the Gulf War, we will not tolerate aggression across borders, and we will keep our commitments to friends and partners. Yet we must acknowledge that a strategy based solely upon the narrow pursuit of these interests will not fill an empty stomach or allow someone to speak their mind. Moreover, failure to speak to the broader aspirations of ordinary people will only feed the suspicion that has festered for years that the United States pursues our interests at their expense.
Some are calling President Obama's speech a movement toward democracy, but others warn the real story in the Middle East is being overlooked, the threat from Iran. Julie Stahl has the story now from Jerusalem.
If you read the headlines and listen to news reports, recent Arab revolutions mean a move toward freedom throughout the Middle East. While the world focuses on these events, it could be missing signs of hard times ahead for Israel and the region.
The worst case scenario facing Israel right now is that the U.S. administration and the European Union and NATO are all so distracted by all the wars and rumors of wars and uprisings that their eyes are off of Iran. Iran is the strategic mortal threat to Israel at this point.
Author Joel Rosenberg tells CBN News that while Osama bin Laden's death is useful for Israel and the U.S., it's not a game changer.
The leadership in Iran and their feverish pursuit of nuclear weapons is the issue in the Middle East, bar none. And everything else is important, but essentially they're sideshow struggles to the main event. And yet the sideshows are sucking up all the political bandwidth in Washington and Brussels and elsewhere.
Iranian leaders could be using those sideshows to their own benefit. CBN News first reported on a secret video produced in Iran that predicts the revolutions will eventually lead to the appearance of the Mahdi, or Islamic Messiah. In Jerusalem for his Epicenter conference, Rosenberg calls the Iranian version of the end of the world a photographic negative of biblical end times theology.
And so in their case, they believe that to hasten the coming of the 12th Imam, the Messiah, you have to kill millions and millions and millions of people, obliterate Israel, and then annihilate the United States, and then the end shall come.
He sees the Middle East situation getting harder.
My sense of things at this point is that things are going to get worse for Israel. I don't see good coming out at this stage from what we've just seen happen in Egypt. Egypt's making very dangerous moves towards Iran when they have been at odds, towards Hamas, as Hamas builds this alliance now with Fatah, which is a disaster for the peace process.
Julie Stahl, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Police have issued 11 criminal warnings to those who disrupted a worship service at San Antonio's Cornerstone Church. This past Sunday, Pastor John Hagee dedicated services to the importance of standing with Israel. Several people stood up, shouted, and disrupted his sermon with an illegal protest. Here's a brief look. As you see, churchgoers applauded as security officers escorted the trespassers from the building. Police were able to issue warnings for trespass after that. Cornerstone was one of hundreds of churches that participated in Christians United for Israel's third annual event. Hagee released a statement about the incident saying, quote, "We support Israel because Israel has the right to exist." For more reaction to this story, log on to our website, cbnnews.com. Joint Chiefs Chairman Mike Mullen is concerned too much information has leaked out about the operation and the elite team that took out Osama bin Laden. Mullen says it is time for former and current U.S. officials to stop talking. Still, Americans have always been fascinated with the Navy SEALs, how they train, what they do, and who they are. And former SEALs are giving people a glimpse into their world. Just one day after the world learned the SEALs killed bin Laden, the Walt Disney Company put in the paperwork to trademark the name SEAL Team 6. The application states Walt Disney intends to use the name for a range of products like toys and games. The sale of pins, buttons, books, patches, and just about everything Navy SEAL has skyrocketed. America is fascinated. The SEAL team sent to get bin Laden actually trains right here in Virginia Beach, and this resort city is crawling with Navy SEAL and bin Laden merchandise, like this t-shirt which says, "We got him." But for those looking for more than just t-shirts and bumper stickers, there is something a bit more adventurous. This is the Extreme SEAL Experience in Chesapeake, Virginia. These aren't real SEALs, just regular guys looking for adventure and a challenge.
Back straight, heads up.
Former Navy SEAL Senior Chief Don Shipley runs the place. His phone rings off the hook since bin Laden's death. His website had so many hits, it shut down. Shipley hires other former SEALs to help out. These guys have been on combat missions all over the world and know what it takes to be part of one of America's most elite teams.
Well, the guys that come down here are that cut above, and that becomes the pleasure of running this. They're also looking to get that eye of the tiger thing back they had in their college football days. And, you know, now they're stuck in an office cubicle and they've lost it.
While most people spend vacation on the beach, basking in the sun, these weekend warriors head to the SEAL Challenge for a taste of what real SEAL training is like.
This is fun, but pushes you.
This is Mark Paris. Back home in New York, he's an electrician.
And I'm 51, so it gets me to that line. And then I have to push myself past it. Make life a little exciting. Doing pretty good for old man.
One, two, three.
John Speaker works for a cable company in Texas. He's here looking for a challenge and to get pushed to the limit.
I don't want to wake up at 80 years old and say I wish I would have. During it, it stinks, you know, it's tough. But the reward afterwards is what everybody's pushing for.
Guys come here for different reasons. So one of the first things we teach them is about reaching deep inside themselves.
We've got to be at the drop point for them at 10:30.
These guys will likely never gear up for a real combat mission, but after going through this week-long extreme course, they have a new respect and admiration for the Navy SEALs. The number of people applying for unemployment fell sharply for the second straight week. Applications for benefits dropped 29,000 from the previous week, the Labor Department says. Economists say this could point to a slowly recovering job market. Businesses have been working to create more jobs over the last 3 months, adding 250,000 jobs per month, the fastest hiring spree in about 5 years. Americans will begin heading out on summer vacations in the next few weeks, or will they? Gas is $4 or more a gallon in some parts of the country, and that has some people rethinking their travel plans. Heather Sells has more.
The big question for this summer is just how consumers will respond to rising gas prices. Many experts believe they will simply drive less. And what's perhaps even more unclear is whether Washington can pull together and come up with a solution to fix this long-term crisis.
Energy independence means that we need to develop our full spectrum of energy resources here in the United States of America. That means we should be drilling.
Republicans like Congressman Alan West want to increase drilling here at home and the pursuit of other energy sources. And even President Obama is now talking about new oil and gas leases in the Gulf of Mexico and Alaska's National Petroleum Reserve.
We should increase safe and responsible oil production here at home.
But some on Wall Street say when the president uses the word safe and responsible, he's really just winking at environmentalists. Meanwhile, Democrats on Capitol Hill are blaming oil speculators
and trying to slash tax breaks for oil companies.
I think we found when these oil company executives testified before Congress last week that at least one of them said that, you know, supply and demand would mean that oil prices really should be about $60 to $70 a barrel. That would mean for Washington drivers, we'd be paying $2.50 a gallon instead of $4 a gallon.
But on Tuesday, a vote to repeal $2 billion a year in tax breaks for oil companies failed. Republicans say ending the tax breaks will not help to drive down prices at the pump. Senator John Cornyn of Texas saying, "This is not an energy strategy. This is a public relations strategy. This is a how do I get reelected strategy. It does not solve the problem or the pain that Americans are feeling at the pump." Americans are already taking steps to respond to that pain. And here's one answer that you may see sooner rather than later. It's a GPS-like device that gives real-time information about how much gas you're using.
Essentially, you don't want to accelerate too hard. You don't want to brake too fast. You want to coast to your stops.
The national average for a gallon of unleaded gasoline right now is $3.94. But with Memorial Day just a little over a week away, it's unclear how long that average will last. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Coming up, why customers of a popular craft store are being targeted by criminals.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
The Presbyterian Church USA is making it easier to ordain gays and lesbians. The nomination dropped a policy requiring unmarried clergy to remain celibate. That leaves the final decision whether to ordain gays up to regional district leaders. About 100 of the 11,000 PCUSA churches have already left the denomination over the issue. The Institute on Religion and Democracy tells CBN News more churches will now follow suit.
Where they will end up is a good question. Some congregations that have already departed have chosen to join more conservative Presbyterian bodies, such as the Evangelical Presbyterian Church or the Presbyterian Church in America. However, the exodus that we're probably going to see is larger than either of those denominations could probably absorb. So there's also a possibility that a new Presbyterian body would come into existence.
And while many churches have left the denomination, some conservative congregations have decided to stay for now. South Carolina is the latest state to propose a bill making gold and silver coins legal tender. More than a dozen other states are considering similar moves. Rising inflation and the nation's weak economy is leading to the new focus on gold. Tea Party leaders and conservative economists say using gold would help restrain government spending and keep the central bank's power in check. Some customers at a popular craft store are being targeted by criminals. The crook stole the debit card information from the Michaels chain. Authorities say the scammers could be in as many as 20 states.
These Chicago area women didn't know each other, but thanks to friends and Facebook, they've helped to unravel a major case. Criminals use their debit card information to withdraw from both their accounts.
They were from ATMs that were from nowhere that I've ever been to.
Gatz and Brandy Raimundo told mutual friends about the thefts. Those friends introduced them on Facebook. Then they discovered they both shopped at Michaels, the popular crafts chain.
I couldn't believe it because it's such a well-known store. It's a huge chain.
There had to be some type of skimming device that was capturing it and assuming our PIN numbers.
It turns out that crime rings know how to replace or reprogram PIN pads right in the checkout lane, like at Michaels. They can then easily capture customers' debit card numbers and PINs.
When we're using a technology as old as a magnetic strip on a card that can easily be duplicated, I would definitely be worried, and it makes it extremely easy for the criminals to clone our cards and steal our identities.
Crooks can buy card cloning machines right on the internet, which they apparently did in this case. Michaels now confirms it has found 90 compromised PIN pads in 80 of its stores. Heather Sells, CBN News.
The Federal Communications Commission is getting into the controversy over cell phones that track your whereabouts. The agency is asking the telecom industry to attend a public forum in Washington next month. Its goal is to help consumers protect their privacy. USA Today reports location tracking systems are built into Apple's iPhone and Google's Android. There may be some added health benefits to that morning cup of coffee. Harvard University researchers discovered men who drink 6 cups a day reduce their risk of developing prostate cancer by 60%. At the same time, a new Swedish study shows women who drink 5 cups a day lower their risk of developing an especially aggressive form of breast cancer. Both studies suggest coffee contains hundreds of potent antioxidants, but there are some downsides. Coffee still causes jitters, heart palpitations, and insomnia. Up next, you're going to meet a little boy who died and went to heaven, and also see what he had to say about it.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come explore Jerusalem, where Jesus opened blind eyes. Visit the hills of Galilee, where Jesus fed the multitude. Stroll through Capernaum, where Jesus lived and taught and healed. To learn more about standing where it all happened in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come visit Capernaum, where Jesus restored a paralytic's helpless legs. Sail the Sea of Galilee, where Jesus walked on the water. Stroll through the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus healed a servant's ear. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
World-renowned astrophysicist Stephen Hawking is making headlines not because of his science, but because of his beliefs about eternity. Hawking says heaven does not exist. He told the Guardian newspaper there is no heaven. That is a fairy story for people afraid of the dark. He says he believes in science over religion. Some people put weight in Hawking's opinions because of his scientific awards. A year ago, Hawking caused a stir when he warned aliens might exist, and if so, they could very well be unfriendly to humans. Stephen Hawking may not believe in heaven, but the family you're about to meet sure does. When Colton Burpo was 4, he had his appendix burst. After that, his spirit left his body during the emergency room surgery. Those desperate moments rocked his parents' faith, but what he later told them about heaven was an even bigger shock.
And we knew we were in bad shape when they said, well, you need to come out the hallway. They separated us from everyone else, and then someone came to us and started talking to us that we got to have surgery on your kid.
It was tough. Seeing your boy be lifeless when he was a very vibrant child.
And it was at that moment that we were looking at each other. I remember my wife holding Colton in that hallway, just us. He's not even moving. And I just broke down and I was mad at God. I just frustrated. Fed up. And I remember telling him, I said, God, after all I've done for you, and now you're going to take my kid? This is how you treat your pastors? Then I remember the nurse coming out, is Colton's daddy out here? I'm like, yeah, well, Colton's in recovery. And I remember my son in that room then looking up at me and goes, Dad, do you know I almost died?
And that's where I got to see heaven.
And I said, so Colton, what did Jesus look like?
I knew that the first person I saw was Jesus. He was wearing white robes with a purple sash, and he just came down nicely and gracefully.
Dad, Jesus has markers. I didn't know what he meant. So I finally asked the right question, Colton, where are Jesus' markers? And he drops his toys down, and he stands up, and he just points, Dad, they were right here. He takes his fingers, points to the palms, then he bends over and touches the tops of his feet and looks up to me, and that's where Jesus' markers were, Dad.
When I was in the throne room of God to start with, so I got to see what that looked like. I was upset because I didn't know what was happening. What God did is he used people or things that I liked to calm me down. From there on, I felt better.
And one day we're traveling together and he looks up at me and, Dad, you used to have a grandpa named Pop, didn't you? I'm like, yeah, he's really nice. Really? Yeah, you used to play with him as a kid and work with him on the farm and shoot stuff with him. And I'm like, yeah, how do you know that? Well, he told me.
A figure came up and he was Pop. He asked me, are you Todd's son? I said, yes. He said that he was his grandpa, so that's where I met him.
Yeah, Pop, I was very close to him, and he was my most significant male role model when I was a kid growing up. But he was killed in a car wreck before I turned 7.
I was busy paying bills again, because that's my job, and he came up and told me he had 2 sisters. Well, he had to say it several times before he finally got my attention. And finally, I put myself down and looked at him and says, what do you mean you have 2 sisters? No, I have 2 sisters. You had a baby die in your tummy. And I just looked at him like, well, how do you know you have 2 sisters? Well, she told me. And then he proceeded to describe her.
She looked like Cassie, but she had brown hair. And first time when she saw me, she just came up and hugged me.
We knew this was true because he said she kept hugging me. She wouldn't stop hugging me, Mom, and I didn't like that.
Well, I'm not really the hugging type.
I had miscarried the weekend of Father's Day weekend, which made it even rougher. And we thought we'd dealt with it. We'd gotten over it. We accepted that the baby had died. But when he said he had 2 sisters, I think I was in shock first and then trying to realize, what is he telling me? And so I knew that he had seen her, and after he described her, and he says, she's just waiting for you guys to come to heaven.
You know, as we talked about heaven and he was telling me all these wonderful details, I just felt like I had to ask him, did he want to come back?
I knew that I was leaving heaven because Jesus came to me and said, Colton, you need to go back. Even though I didn't want to go back, he said that he was answering my dad's prayer.
I remember that prayer. That irreverent, that disrespectful, screaming at God prayer. I was like, he's answering that prayer?
I learned that heaven is for real and you're gonna like it.
A house built to withstand Armageddon, why one man says he'll survive.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin, while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch, and Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
Scripture says Christ will return like a thief in the night, and yet this still does not stop human nature from trying to predict the end of time.
I can't imagine what could destroy it, really. I mean, lightning, tornadoes, hurricanes, fire.
A Tennessee firefighter is not taking any chances. Dean Fontaine purchased what locals notoriously call Millennium Manor. It was hand-built over 40 years ago by a couple who thought they had predicted and could withstand the end of the world. The house is complete with a 3 feet thick stone walls, as well as a dungeon, and is entirely fireproof.
Nobody's going to drop a cigarette here and have the whole house burn up. When you own the only Armageddon-proof house in the area, you're kind of obligated to have a party on every announced Armageddon.
The original owners never lived to see their miscalculation. Fontaine says he tries to keep things in perspective. He just likes to have the house because it looks like a castle. All right, that is going to do it for this edition of CBN News Midday. Remember, you can find information on all the stories you've seen at cbnnews.com. Stay up to date with us as well through Facebook and Twitter. Hope you join us again right here next time. Have a wonderful Thursday.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
Life can be tough. There are challenges for all of us. Jesus told us to pray for one another, and that's exactly what we want to do. On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to bring Christians together to pray for each other, meet others just like you, and talk or share with them in real time. Watch God work miracles in people's lives. Be part of 700 Club Interactive, weekdays at 11 a.m. on cbn.com.